What's up, guys? We're back again for another Come Up Creator interview. Today's episode will be Dani Lioce. She's a drawer and painter out of Chicago.
Hopefully she shows us some of her work and maybe even paints a little picture for us.
Today's a good one. Check it out.
Been a long time coming, it's the Come Up. Been a long damn time, it's the Come Up. Sunflower.
We're here, we're back again with another Come Up Creator interview. Joined with Dani Lioce. Dani, tell us a little something about yourself.
Hey, so I am based here out of Chicago. I'm a artist, painter, drawer, originally from Huntsville, Alabama. I graduated from the University of Dayton. I'm aspiring gallery, museum operations.
So this is one of your pieces behind us, and we have seen a bunch that you have scattered around your house. Do you have a certain type of theme or style that you try to portray?
A lot of my work is based on the human body and the human experience, I would say. And then the style of my painting is very much based on like the expressionist era, kind of. I use a lot of expressive brush strokes and lines to portray the figures that I draw. Like, color-wise, I try to draw feeling out of the colors I use, because I usually stay pretty monochromatic or pretty neutral in the colors I use.
What type of tools do you use to create your art?
So I use oil paint and oil sticks, which are like oil paint condensed down to a stick, pretty much. And then I use a lot of like graphite and pencil.
So you say it's mostly based off the human body and like expressions. Do you use models or do you take pictures on the internet? How do you go about finding that?
Yeah, so it's a little bit of both. In college, of course, we had like painting and drawing, like figure drawing classes, that we would have models come in that were hired that would sit for us for 3 hours, that we would sit there and draw and learn how to draw from real life.
There's gotta be a struggle with the pandemic going on to find models.
I just moved to Chicago because I'm not really not into that community yet, really. Back in college, with some of our models would actually let us like, take pictures, and I have some of those I work from. So I do a little bit of both, like pictures and real life.
As an up-and-coming artist, what are your biggest struggles when it comes to try and find your place in this artistic world?
For me, it comes down to like, do I want to be a working artist per se? Like, do I want to be making and selling artwork, or more of like the professional side of like galleries and the operations of portraying other people's artwork? Right now, I do like a little bit of both. I mean, I make a lot of art, but I also am working to find, you know, like jobs and galleries. And especially like artist-run galleries, I find interesting because it's not as much like the buying and selling of artwork, it's the giving local artists like the platform.
From what you've been telling us, you don't have a big prominent name on social media.
Right.
Is there a reason behind that?
I guess it's an intimidation factor of like whether it's good enough or whether it's finished.
That's fair. That's one of like a repetitive theme that we've been seeing as we're doing these interviews, that it's hard for a lot of people to put themselves out there.
I've been thinking about it a lot lately, actually, that I want to like take more pictures and how I would be comfortable in doing that. And I think instead of like taking a picture and posting it, I could take process pictures and then like show that kind of more rather than just like, here's a finished piece and like, what do you think about it? Rather like take who's viewing it like along the ride with you kind of.
We've came into your house and you have a bunch of canvases mm-hmm. with a ton of your art. What do you plan on doing with them? Do you try to sell them, or do you wish to one day hold on to them so you can show in that gallery?
I have people asking me for art all the time, like my siblings and family members and friends. So I guess I would like to start selling artwork, and even if it's as like a side hobby. Yeah, so.
So when we walked in here at first, you were doing a painting which was for a client.
Yeah, so I was reached out by someone from Detroit that wanted me to paint something for their living room. Not something I've ever done before, so it's kind of slow going right now, but I'm kind of incorporating the Detroit skyline with a figure because they like music a lot. They kind of gave me a list of things that they liked and that they wanted. I worked with the figure, so I wanted to include that somewhere in it. And then my style, I'm trying to keep true to with like working in thin layers of paint with the line drawings and the expressive brushstrokes.
Because obviously what we noticed, it doesn't look anything like your typical art.
Definitely.
So when it comes to your art, do you have any people that like dominantly influence your style?
Yes. So especially in college when like art professors would give us lists of names of artists, I can't ignore the name Jenny Saville, who is a very prominent female artist that portrays the female figure. Very prominent. I think any like female figure drawer right now probably would have to list her name. And then there's other ones like Alex Konevsky, who's a figure painter. He abstracts the figure a lot with his painting, which is interesting for me.
If you were to have like a goal for the next month, could you give an example?
I definitely want to make more artwork.
Trying to stay on the grind.
Yeah, stay on the grind, make some stuff, make that a priority. Get my foot in the door in a gallery somewhere would be really awesome.
And then ultimate goal?
Ultimate goal would maybe be one day to open up our own artist-run gallery.
Awesome. Tell us what's going on in this one.
So this one is a print, that monotype process I had mentioned earlier. So I painted it on plexiglass first. Then this is like a piece of paper that you roll with it. So what I really like about this is like it's additive and subtractive. So the paint is all additive, but then you can go in with like your nail or the end of a paintbrush and kind of sketch out like more detailed areas.
I've seen her artwork. Dani, Lioce, hopefully we see you in a gallery one day.
Hopefully.
Achieving your goals, running your own. Thank you so much for having us in your house and showing us everything.
Thank you for having me.
Watch her story on the come up, alright? Stay tuned.
Ooh.
And that's a wrap. Connor and I's purchase.
I was gonna say that was the one that was on.
Yeah, but it's actually kind of funny. So that one was in a show, and I just like gave it to them, and I thought that they would figure out which way it was supposed to be hung, and they hung it upside down.
Oh, really?
And then it won an award upside down. So.